Hey Pisces, it's Meg with Padmes, and I'm doing your new moon manifesting reading for May 11th through 17, 2021. And this is for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements. Any cross watchers are welcome here. And we are calling in our angels and guides at the highest vibrations of love and light, because I don't want to talk to anyone else. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at what kind of energy you need to match in order to manifest optimally this Taurus new moon. We're going to look at resistance that you need to work through in order to manifest optimally. What is your new moon energy in present time? This is going to be the situation of what's going on with you right now. And energy that is coming toward you that you may not be seeing, or maybe someone coming toward you. And then also we're going to ask for some advice from your guides. So here is your overall energy. This is the energy that you need to manifest optimally. And this is any resistance, Pisces. So this is your situation during this new moon. And this is energy or someone who's coming toward you. What energy is coming toward you during this time? And advice. All right. We're going to clarify this, and then we're going to pull from the crystal oracle. So the overall energy is talking about some unfinished business. So there's some loose ends that need to be tied up, or at least there's some resolution that needs to be had. We'll clarify this and figure out what kind of resolution this is. Is it a hug it out situation? Can it be resolved in this way? Or is it some kind of situation that needs resolution within you that you're going to have to do on your own? We'll find out. And the energy you need in order to manifest optimally this month is talking about being open to receive. It's basically seeing things as a yes rather than seeing things as a maybe or a no. It's like you're being offered this cup of love, and this is about you accepting what the universe is offering you. Being in receiving mode. This can also be in giving mode, but I'm feeling more so it's about receiving. This is also being in a space of heightened awareness. This bunny rabbit's ears are straight up, and I'm totally noticing them. This is also about listening to your guides. It's feeling into situations, it's being open and receptive, but this is about listening to what wants to come in, being open in that way, not just in the heart chakra to receive, but being open like your ear chakras, your clairaudient chakras, being open to what it is that you're hearing. Okay, let's look at what resistance is going on. So this is about, there's resistance. It's like you feel like there, you don't have the whole picture. Like there's something that's missing. There's some bit of the puzzle that is not, that's not there. A need to really step outside of the bubble, step outside of the fire and look in from the outside, kind of like the bird's eye view. There's more information that's needed in order to see the big picture. So there's resistance to seeing that big picture. So being aware of that before making any decisions. What's interesting too is your situation and the energy that's coming toward you, but there's a lot of swords here. There's a lot of being in your mind, being in your headspace, but there's also this kind of like lying, cheating, stealing energy. I kind of feel like someone's trying to pull the wool over your eyes, or someone's telling you some things. It's like they're telling you half truths, or they're telling you the truth, but they're not telling you the whole story. That's what it is, the situation. You're like, I'm resistant to not hearing the whole truth and nothing but the truth. But the situation at hand is like, there's some kind of, somebody's running away from the truth. Somebody's not telling you the truth or the full truth for some reason. And the energy that's coming toward you, I feel like somebody's trying to say, oh, that's in the past. Let's not worry about the past. Let's just move toward the future. But that's like, you know, building a tower moment, right? It's like building a foundation with a crack in it and building the tower up on top of it. The energy that's coming toward you also, though, because this Five of Swords is reversed, this is you figuring out the whole picture, whether they tell you what it is or whether your intuition gives you the clue. Clairaudience. But also, this is about like listening between the lines, reading between the lines, hearing between the lines, hearing what people are actually saying when they're not saying it directly. This is you getting to the bottom of not having the big picture. But there's definitely somebody who's trying to, it's almost like kind of like trying to get away with something. They just don't want to deal with it. We're going to clarify all of this. Your advice from your guides is talking about being action oriented when it comes to things that you are passionate about. So even though all this stuff is going on and there's some unfinished business here, loose ends or resolution that needs to happen, don't let that stop you from totally going forward, being action oriented in the things that drive you, the things that make you passionate. Don't let this, yeah, and I'm even feeling my solar plexus in this. When this kind of thing happens, it takes away your personal power, or it's controlling, and it's somebody trying to control the situation or control what it is that you know. And that feels like someone's trying to take your power. And literally it's because they feel like they're not powerful, or whatever it is that they're trying to keep from you, that information keeps them from being powerful. So your advice is talking about not letting this person's energy affect your inspiration and what you want to do with it. Let's do some clarifying of that. Shall we, Pisces? Let's do this. All right. So first, let's get some clarification on this. What resolution is wanting to happen? What kind of resolution is wanting to happen here? What do we need to bring full circle? Interesting too, because this is about being in your mind. This is about having, I'm even hearing heavy thoughts, having heavy thoughts. These are past programs. These are past beliefs. These are past stories that could have been true at one time, but the question that this card wants to ask is, are those stories true now? This is like a self-imposed prison or self-imposed limitations. So this is something you can take yourself out of. I almost feel like it's a wrap up, like you've been working on this, but there's still some unresolved, unfinished business around this, and you're bringing that together now. You're bringing that to a close. I feel also like this has to do with following your intuition. It's like old past beliefs about not being able to perhaps trust yourself and getting to a place where you're like, you know what? I do trust myself. I do trust myself, and I trust what I hear, and I am of sound mind. My intuition is spot on. That's what I'm hearing, Pisces. My intuition is spot on. Wow. Okay. Let's go ahead and clarify that intuition. This little bunny rabbit offering you a cup of love, offering you that opportunity to listen again to your intuition. Be in that receiving space, right? And here's the magician reversed. The reason why that's coming in so strongly about being able to trust your intuition is because someone has tried to get you to very specifically not trust your intuition. And your intuition is one of the strongest things about you, Pisces. So anyone who's trying to befuddle you in some way is trying to take your power. And that's what this magician upside down is all about. This is manipulation. So this energy, this receiving energy, this is about releasing any victimization around that too, though. Victimization energy is definitely not receiving energy. This is recognizing this energy and it being freeing for you. So instead of being victimized by it, it's more like, oh, I see you. I see you. So that allows you to see what kind of energy is around you, what kind of energy is going on without pulling it into your field. Once you're aware of it, you can say, no, you don't match me. Send it down your grounding cord, get it out of your field. Let's look at this resistance about needing to know the big picture. And this resistance is talking about the Five of Wands. You know, what's really interesting is it's like, so here's the resistance, knowing this big picture, possibly storming in and acting before you have all the information. So being aware of that, but also getting this information that you're not getting from someone else is going to be a lot easier. It's going to be more easier and more effortless than you actually realize. So keeping that in mind, this is also about releasing tension and struggle around receiving this information. The less you struggle with trying to get it, the more open you'll become and the more it'll just flow in. It'll just flow into you and you'll just have knowingness about it. Let's look at this situation where someone's running from the truth, but also lying, cheating, stealing, like not telling you everything. The energy that you're dealing with is really pushing you to rely on self. Wow, look at that. We've got the Page of Cups twice and it's reversed. This is also about telling the universe no. So for instance, if you recognize that someone is trying to befuddle you and you say, no, you can't do that. You're telling the universe very clearly what it is that you will accept and what it is that you won't accept into your life energetically, which is awesome because then the universe will give you more of that, right? So let's take a look at the energy that's coming toward you. And it's almost like somebody's trying to put something under the rug or somebody's trying to minimize betrayal. Oh, it's in the past. Let's move forward. Let's move on. Let's not worry about this anymore. But I mean, there's unfinished business up here. There's unresolved things in the past that need resolution. And this can't be minimized. This can't be just put under the rug, you know, this energy that's coming toward you. Let's clarify it. It needs to be dealt with. And whether or not that person is going to deal with it, you have to deal with it, Pisces, right? Again, death card reversed. So here we have the World reversed and here we have death. It's like still in transition. So this is something I feel like this person is not going to kind of come correct with. You're not going to get that resolution by hugging it out is what I'm trying to say, Pisces. So that means you're going to have to resolve it within yourself. Recognizing that it's there is how that's going to be resolved for you intrinsically. Let's look at your advice, Pisces, your advice for this human energy here. And we've got the Ten of Wands reversed. So here again, this King of Wands is talking about being action oriented, about getting what it is that you are inspired by, going for it, not letting all of this unresolved stuff. I don't want to say stupid stuff that this person is throwing at you. This guy is overlooking that, like not overlooking it, not throwing it away, but he's rising above it. He rises above it. He doesn't let it bother him. He releases other people's unresolved issues out of his space. He's not here to process somebody else's stuff. This is also about releasing an agreement, or many agreements really, but releasing agreements or responsibilities that are not yours that you're processing for other people. This is about creating your own agreement that makes sense with your present time timeline. Okay. So Pisces, let's take a look at this crystal oracle. What do your guides want to tell you? And your guides are talking about quantum quattro. I'm just going to look that up. Quantum quattro, self-understanding. You are an extremely complex person who is seeking wholeness within yourself. Examine all facets of your personality, especially those you hide from yourself or others. Accept those of value. Find the gift hidden deep within mistakes. Forgive and let go. Release yourself from codependencies and abusive relationships. Heal your inner child. Recognize the resources you have to draw on. I'm loving that, Pisces. Okay, I'm going to read the divination too. Karmic aspects need healing. Your question is nowhere near as straightforward as it seems, so dig deep and see all the sides. The power of the whole is much greater than its component parts. And once you have all the information, you are invincible and you evolve rapidly. Wow. Pisces, that's perfect. Happy manifesting, Pisces. Let me know how this resonates, and I will see you soon.